In the Central Bank Bankruptcy Curing Supervisory Research on Consultation, the Reserve Bank of India has responded to a query seeking explanation for its reason to ban banks from the line with the cryptocurrency industry, admitting it conducted no research prior to its prohibitive action. In a right to information request filed by a domestic lawyer, Varun Sethi, the Reserve Bank of India was over a number of questions, plainly asked for the reason behind its April ban that explicitly forbade all regulated financial institutions from providing service to cryptocurrency businesses. RBI confirmed it gave little to no thought before reaching the decision in its response, nor did it conduct any research, internally or independently, before enforcing the ban. In what is increasingly appearing to be an arbitrary action, the central bank did not clarify its position and plainly refused to answer other probing questions put forth in the information request. For instance, central bank officials were asked if the authority established an internal committee to determine if there were risks in trading cryptocurrency. No, was the answer. Had the RBI conducted its own research, or even communicated with other counterparts, think Japan, to understand and explore regulatory framework prior. Again, no. The RBI also refused to clarify how it had determined public risk in engaging cryptocurrency from as early as 2013. Similarly, it refused to disclose its take on the acknowledged self-regulated cryptocurrency exchanges that follow key ICO norms. If it has sought an external expert opinion before annexing the ban, or it will prohibit Indian citizens from buying cryptocurrency from exchanges outside the country. The central bank ducked all these questions by pointing to a loophole in the RTI Act and painting them from giving an answer. The RBI's ban in April came after years of repeated public warnings by the financial regulator, cautioning citizens against trading or investing cryptocurrency like Bitcoin. Last month, the central bank pushed back against a Supreme Court appeal petition that sought regulation to effectively legalize and recognize the cryptocurrency industry in the country. In fact, the RBI deflected responsibility in outlining a policy or framework for the NASDAQ sector, stating, "The RBI cannot unilaterally decide for the government on the legality of a Bitcoin." In India, a number of cryptocurrency businesses has signed field petition at state court arguing the RBI decision was arbitrary, unfair, and unconstitutional. Witnessing an increasing backlog of those petitions, India's Supreme Court barred all high court from filing further petition against the Reserve Bank and claimed all pending petitions in May.